clutch and not so much. So everybody, I had those guys that came up huge for them in week one, and those other guys that maybe they should have been sitting on the bench and swapped out for somebody else. So guys, tell me who was your clutch and you're not so much week one.
Well, I'll tell you right away, the guy who came up clutch for me, and it was a losing effort. In our home league, I played against Kevin, and Kevin's team went bananas, and my team put up a valiant effort, but it was no match for what Kevin threw out there. But my clutch performer, Calvin Ridley this week. The guy had 9 catches for 130 yards and 2 touchdowns, and that was big, especially when we were all kind of thinking that it would maybe be, you know, the Matt Ryan Julio show down there. For Calvin Ridley to come up big, that was really unexpected for him to have that kind of a performance. At least I wasn't expecting it, so that was nice.
For me, it's going to be a pair of Packers, and it's going to be Aaron Rodgers and Davante Adams. We did say this leading into the season, and week one held true, that Adams is the guy there in Green Bay. Now, they did sprinkle in some Alan Lazard. Marquez Valdez-Scantling got some nice runs, so it looks like they were really trying to diversify their offense a little bit. But when Rodgers needed to make something happen, it was Davante Adams all the time. 14 for 156 and 2 touchdowns against a Minnesota team that was a little flat. They did not look prepared to play, and historically does really well against Aaron Rodgers the last couple of years. I think the last 4 games against Aaron Rodgers, they've allowed 4 passing touchdowns. Well, Rodgers smoke showed them here in week one and just went bananas on them. So those two guys for me were definitely clutch. One being that I have Adams, and that was one of the key driving factors that led me to beating the pants off of Alex here. Not so much for me, Saquon Barkley. Did he realize that they were on primetime television on Monday night and just forgot to show up? Like, what the hell? Like, he came out after the game and owned it, so I guess good on him for owning it. But, dude, like, you are supposed to be the focal point of that offense, and you were terrible. So anybody who took Saquon has got to be pulling their hair out already week one. Now, I think he'll bounce back, but it was a very, very dismal performance to kick off the season, and you don't want to see that for a guy that you probably took first, second, or third overall in most leagues.
My clutch performer of the week was a guy that I've been touting all offseason, and a guy that I had ranked exceptionally high at the quarterback position. That was Kyler Murray. He was a saving grace for me in our home league because I was up against an Aaron Rodgers performance that just went off. And looking at that thing was looking like I was going to take the L. Kyler happened to play a little bit later and save some bacon there. And one in which we saw Kyler show up and do some rushing, something that we thought we would see a little bit more of last year. He definitely showed that up against a good Niners defense and had 100 yards rushing right up until, you know, they do a kneel down in shotgun formation. Somebody maybe need to tell Cliff Kingsbury that he can get up under center and do a kneel down there, but we'll take it. 91 rushing yards, 230 yards through the air, and a couple of touchdowns, 1 passing, 1 rushing. So Kyler Murray, definitely the clutch performer of the week on the Mean Machine team. But we were also followed up with a not so much out of Nick Chubb, a guy that, you know, I've been talking all off season and was a guy that I actually have competing for the rushing title, and it's one that has me rethinking that a little bit now. Nick Chubb finishing running back 50 on the week and really just did not have a great game against a salty Baltimore defense. But again, just did not show up very well as the rest of that Cleveland offense just didn't show up in a good way.
All right. So I saved my not so much because this one hurts. It hurts personally. It hurts that it was my starting quarterback in like every league that I've ever had for the last 5 years. Carson Wentz. He was my not so much this week. He got 270 yards through the air and he had 2 touchdowns. The unfortunate thing is he also threw 2 picks. He lost a fumble and he got sacked 8 times. And if you play in a league, which I'm in a league where you get penalized for sacks, that ends up hurting you a lot. Those 8 sacks end up costing me. And so Carson Wentz was my not so much performer. I think that not having that rushing attack out of Miles Sanders probably hurt some things. But I'll tell you what, I checked that box score in the first half. I see that Carson's got 2 touchdowns. The Eagles are up 17-0. I kind of quit paying attention to that game, went about my business on Sunday. And then next thing I know, Washington scores 27 straight points. Carson looks like a rookie again in the second half. So that O-line, man, they've got some issues. The injuries obviously have decimated that. And I think, you know, I kind of knew going in that the O-line might be a little suspect, but yikes, I didn't expect it to be that bad. So Carson Wentz, my not so much performer for week 1.